If you're trying to export to an MP4 from After Effects, but you don't see the option in the render settings, you're in the right place. In this video, I'll be showing you exactly how you can render to an MP4 using Adobe Media Encoder with After Effects. Let's get into it. A lot of the time, After Effects defaults to QuickTime to export your videos, which can result in huge file sizes. With the .H.264 codec, it converts your project into an MP4 file, which is ideal for sharing online. In order to make this work, you're going to need to download Adobe Media Encoder if you don't have it already. With Encoder installed, what we want to do is go into our After Effects project and choose File, Export, and Add to Adobe Media Encoder Queue. What this is going to do is open up your project in Adobe Media Encoder. To set up our project for exporting, we want to click on our project and click on where it says .H.264. This will bring up the export settings, which you'll probably see is pretty similar to Premiere Pro. If you click on the format menu, it opens up and shows you a variety of different formats that you can export your video as. For the MP4, we want to choose .H.264. Now, when I export my projects, I usually choose Match Source High Bitrate, but if you're exporting for something specific, I recommend you explore these different options here. With all of this configured, we can then give our project a name and find it a place to live. With that done, all you need to do is click OK, and we can go ahead and press the play button in Adobe Media Encoder. You'll be able to see each frame of your project rendering in this little window down here. And the progress bar will give you an estimation of how long's left for your render. Once Media Encoder has finished exporting your project, you'll see a little tick to the right of the list. Now, if we go into our project file, we'll be able to see that our project is rendered out as an MP4. And that's all there is to it. If you found this video useful, give it a thumbs up and comment your thoughts below. And for more Creative Fix tutorials, hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you in the next one.